Hello everyone, today I am going to give you a quick tutorial on how to implement a system which recognizes the face via sparse representation. So let's just run this file first and see the output. So in the meanwhile it is running, let me tell you, in this video I am implementing the face recognition algorithm that proposed in robust force recognition via sparse representation. So you can see after running this file, you can see a GUI which is titled as robot face recognition tool. So let's just first train the data set by pressing on the train button. Here you can see I have uploaded a face database. So let's just upload the train data first. So it is loading and okay. Now just train the test data by pressing on the test data and uploading it. Okay. Now we have trained the test data and the train data. So let's just test the face images by clicking on the single test. Let's just select a picture. Let's just select 4.pgm. Here you can see a .pgm extension. This is basically because this is a clear grayscale image. This is the tested image, and you can see a detected image as well. Now let's just select another image. Let's say 2.pgm. Okay, this is the test image and this is basically the detected image. These are similar, so it is working. Here it is recognizing the face images. Let me tell you what is happening, what is going inside this output. I have uploaded a face database in which I have included two folders named as test data and train data. In train data, I have uploaded some images of some specific people, and in the test data as well, I have uploaded images of the same persons but on a different angle. So we are just checking whether it is detecting the same image or not. So here it is detecting. Let's just test one more time. Let's just see this 20th and the 5.pgm. yes, it is recognizing. You can see here is the image in the test image, which is the person is wearing sunglasses, and in the detector's image it is not wearing, and these are the images of the same person and it is detecting. So you can see it is giving the accurate results. Now let's just test the multi-test button by clicking on multi-test, and let's just train the database. See, it is asking, are these images similar? So we can say yes. Asking for other also. So we just need to train first by, if we are pressing multi-test, we just need to train the whole database by giving the answers. So it can train, like if they are asking, are images similar? These are not. So we can press no. And these images are similar. So we can say yes. This is also similar. This is also same. Similar. So there are like thousands of images. These are not similar, so we can say no. We just need to train for multi-test like this, and then we can test it up. So this was the output. Now let's just understand this code. Before explaining the code, let me tell you the general fundamental issues in face recognition. The choices of feature, there are basically two general issues which we will suffer when we implement any face recognition tool. The first is the choice of feature transformation. We don't know what feature we need to transform. And the second one is the robustness to corruption, occlusion and discus. So that's why I am using face recognition via sparse representation. So let's just understand the code. In this, we are creating a GUI first in this code, which we can see that was the GUI. And after that, this is the code which is just execute before face recognition tool is visible. We are basically setting the buttons, toggle buttons, and their visibility. And at the and after that, we are updating the handle structure. After that, we are making a function for the outputs that are returned to the command line. This is basically that function. And after that, we are implementing a code for executes on buttons in push button. When we are pressing the push buttons, what is executing? That is basically the function for this. After that, we are training the set folder in this. After training, there are basically three buttons for train, for single test, and for multi-test. So here it is the code for the push button execution. This is for test image. After that, we are doing sparse representation, and at the last we are displaying the output. So this was the code for robust face recognition tool via sparse representation. Thank you for watching.